Greetings, dear friends. I present to your attention the most common malfunctions and breakdowns that occur on the Nissan X-Trail T30. Of course, the Nissan X-Trail is also front-wheel drive, but unlike its relative in the face of Nissan Qashqai, there are very few mono-drive cars. An all-wheel drive with the electromagnetic clutch, which has already become familiar to Japanese and Asian cars, and the rear axle drive is made as simple and quite efficient as possible. It is enough to overcome small obstacles, although it doesn't tolerate prolonged slipping and pulling on heavy ground. After a run of 50-70,000 km, the clutch usually requires flushing in bulkheads, otherwise, by the end of the same run, one can expect damage to the electromagnet and possibly the bearings due to corrosion, and this will cost at least 50,000 rubles for a new clutch and bearings, and the work is not worth a penny. The clutch together with the main gear should be opened and cleaned immediately after overcoming deep force. The breather often lets water through. However, in this case, the wheel bearings most likely will also not last long, and it's better to once again treat the body with anti-corrosive and wash it from below. Yes, this car is not intended for such tests. On the mechanical side, there are a minimum of complaints about the transmission, but you still have to do something. On running machines, the CV joints should be carefully checked, and after 1,500 mileage, it is worth preemptively renewing the lubricant in the hinges, without waiting for them to overheat and the appearance of noise. The propeller shaft after the same 1,500 or 200,000 mileage will require replacing the intermediate support, and in the case of severe operating conditions and crosses, since non-original parts are inexpensive. The transfer case, which is really just a bevel gear, holds up pretty well. If you change the oil and do not overload, then there are no particular problems with it. With a gasoline 280 horsepower turbo engine, it can be rolled up, and in all other cases, damage to shafts and bearings is associated with untimely maintenance, leaks and water ingress into the mechanism or imbalance of the propeller shaft. By the way, gearboxes from the cars before and after restyling are conditionally compatible. The housings differ minimally, but when replacing, you may need to work with a grinder. The mechanism for selecting the gears of manual transmissions with the age greatly loses selectivity due to the stretching of the cables and the loosening of the ball joint of the lever. And the dual mass flywheel has a poorly predictable resource. It is good that, if desired, it is possible to change the clutch to a conventional damper one. After 200,000 mileage, you can expect a deterioration in the inclusion of the third fork gear due to aging synchronizers, and for those who like to drive with a noticeably lower mileage, the synchronizer of the second gear often suffers. At this, with careful maintenance and maintaining the oil level, it all ends, but remember that in the manual transmission it is also necessary to change the oil sometimes. Most of the cars are equipped with automatic transmission. Here is installed the box of a subsidiary of Nissan, Jetco model RE4F04B, which is rightfully considered one of the most successful automatic transmissions of its time. True, there are only four steps, and by middle of the 20s it was already morally outdated, but on the other hand it is reliable and provides good dynamics and comfort. I would say that it is eternal, but exploitation in Russia casts doubt on the reliability of anything. Most of the drivers with a mileage of 280,000 km will require replacement of the blocking lining of the gas turbine engine, but there are always chances that the run was wound up or a racer drove, which made the box literally burn at work. Switching or slipping in third or fourth gears is usually the fault of the brake band. It is here an agent in the first place and is very sensitive to oil contamination. It starts to work harshly. A set of solenoids may fail ahead of time due to excessive pollution or overheating, and the automatic transmission selector often causes a transition to emergency mode. All other repairs are the consequences of either a very high mileage or operation on dirty oil with overheating. The box comes up completely only when half of the clutches die or pieces of metal have destroyed the planetary gear or valve body. This is fine, unless you bought a slightly twitching box. It is usually already a complete corpse inside, so almost everything will have to be changed. However, this is the fate of almost all reliable technology. There will always be someone who will purposefully look for something that can be killed for a long time, and that will not break from this style of handling equipment at once. Frequent oil changes, an additional radiator, and an external filter are recommended but not required. Nissan X-Trail was equipped mainly with two engines, gasoline engines of 2.0 and 2.5 liters of the QR20DE and QR25DE series. supercharged motors of the SR20 VET series, 2 liters and 280 horses, and a 2.2-liter diesel engine of the UD22DDTI series are quite rare. We have such motors, exotic. I can only say that the Nissan turbo engines on this generation are considered very successful, but the diesel engines of our own design are capricious in terms of fuel equipment and very unhurried even in the DSEI version, although they are quite strong. The common difficulties of Nissan engines on the X-Trail are rather weak radiators, unstable pressure in the cooling system due to an unsuccessful plug, often leaking system pipes, somewhat capricious ignition coils, and an intake system with weak corrugation prone to depressurization. Of the most dangerous troubles for the engine and the car, I will name the loss of tightness of the gas line under the hood in the place of the quick detachable connection. The seal ring dubs and little by little leaks appear. The second is weak and corrosive spring clamps on almost all elements of the cooling system, which over time can simply fall apart. On older cars operating in the northern regions after 5-6 years, engine mountings are severely affected. Almost all engine problems begin to manifest themselves after 15,000 mileage. On this front, the chances of overheating and simple control system failures increase dramatically. All this doesn't have the best effect on the condition of the motors, especially when operating in our northern regions. Winter starts at a temperature of 30-35 degrees below zero are quite affordable for these motors, but the chances of ruining the motor increase dramatically, which is reflected in the failure statistics. The naturally aspired 2.0 and 2.5-liter petrol engines are close cousins, although the degree of their unification should not be overestimated. They differ in the cylinder block, the arrangement of a number of components, intake, camshafts, and auxiliary systems. The resource of a larger engine is in fact less than a 2.0-liter one, affected by a greater tendency to overheating and a higher load on the piston and crankshaft. But in any case, it all depends on the style of operation. When changing the oil at least once every 10,000, if the engine is not raped by cold starts all winter, and in the summer it is not overheated in endless traffic jams and trips on the sands, a 2-liter engine will start eating oil with a mileage of 250-280,000 km, and the appetite will grow steadily due to wear of the piston group. If you do not miss the oil level and replace the catalyst with a European metal one or remove it altogether, then the engine will almost certainly last up to 350-400 tons mileage, which for such a simple and cheap design is an undoubted indicator of success. A 2.5-liter engine acquires an oily appetite a little earlier. Cases of its occurrence with brands significantly less than 200,000 mainly appear for the following reasons. Either the mileage is twisted, or the catalyst was not changed in time due to the recall campaign, or the engine was overheated. Because it seems to be a reliable motor, but it has enough nuances. First, the catalyst. The design with the catalyst collector and the ceramic catalyst on Nissan cars turned out to be not very resourceful, and after hundreds of thousands of runs, especially with winter starts, the catalyst began to dust, and some of the dust was sucked back into the cylinders, contributing to a sharp increase in wear of the piston rings and the top of the cylinder and increasing the chances of scoring. The problem was noticed, and from 2003-2004, all cars received a catalyst on a metal substrate, which is noticeably more resistant to overheating and almost doesn't generate dust when destroyed. The measure turned out to be effective, so that restyled motors without overhaul with high mileage are found much more often than pre-restyling ones. At the same time, they abandoned this strange solution in the cooling system, which contributed to the early coking of the rings. In addition to the standard thermostat, which at an opening temperature of 82 degrees and full opening at 96, maintains a very gentle temperature regime of the engine, there is also another thermostat installed, which provides accelerated heating of the cylinder block to 85 degrees. The idea is quite simple. There is practically no liquid circulation in the block until it is fully warmed up, and only after 95 degrees does the antifreeze go through the block in full. This helps to quickly reach the engine temperature regime that is optimal for fulfilling our environmental standards, but this technology has its own unpleasant features. Firstly, most of the operating time there is a large temperature gradient between the cylinder head and the cylinder block, which increases the load on the gas joint and leads to its depressurization. Hence, regularly blowing cylinder head gasket on cars before restyling. Secondly, an increase in the block temperature up to hundreds of degrees raises the temperature of the piston rings and the piston itself, which is expressed in the tendency to coke formation. Well, and the last thing, the circulation of liquid with the second thermostat closed in less. And the stove in the cabin doesn't heat well in cars until it's completely warmed up. The cylinder blocks and cylinder head before and after restyling have differences in the design of the cooling jacket. On a pre-styling motor, you can simply remove the second thermostat without any obvious negative consequences. But putting a thermostat in a new cylinder head will not work. But you can put the old cylinder head on a new block. In this case, installing an additional thermostat is simply harmful. But with runs of about 250,000 to 280,000, the engine eats oil not only because of the cooling system and catalyst. Despite the low operating temperature of the main thermostat, the temperature of the cylinder head in many modes is still quite high. And valve stem seals are already beginning to leak after 5-6 years of operation. Oil leakage from above promotes compression rings, which increases the risk of scraper rings and increases the flow of crankcase gases through the ventilation system, and this speeds up the coking processes. The design of the piston is also not perfect. The rings are thin, the oil drain is designed for low viscosity oils, and the engine doesn't like operation with constant underheating. In the presence of a serious oil appetite, sloppy owners almost always bring the matter to the battery liners and the killed oil pump. The oil level sensors is located too low and the engine crankcase has a weak anti-drain system. So in sharp left turns with a low fuel, the pump suffices. Structurally, the motor is not complicated. Its block is made of aluminum, the sleeves are cast iron, the timing drive is chain, there is only one phase shifter. At 170,000 to 200,000, the timing chain usually needs to be changed, and with stars. With good oil, the resource is longer. There are cases when more than 250,000 chains pass, but this is rare. With a run of about 80-120,000 km, you will have to adjust the valves, and then every 50-60,000 km, the procedure will need to be repeated. The engine doesn't like old candles and dirty fuel very much. With old candles, everything is clear, no one likes them. And the fuel is often very dirty due to the nature of the fuel tank. The fuel system requires periodic flushing, and the injectors even require replacement. It is worth noting that the prices for even original parts are low, and a typical overhaul is almost cheaper than for domestic motors. SR20 VET is a legendary motor. It is the most powerful serial versions of the motor on the CR20 block. The version with the Garrett T28 turbine with a capacity of 280 horsepower is not bad by the standards of high-powered engines. There is also an aluminum block and cast iron sleeves. The camshafts are also driven by a chain, but there are hydraulic lifters, and it has no problem in the cooling system. And an oil burner for it on a stock piston is a rarity. Usually this engine dies for another reason. The UD22DDTI diesel engine is rare and only found on European cars. The motor is chain and mechanically quite strong. The main engine problems are associated with either the fuel equipment or a cracked exhaust manifold, EGR system, dirty intake or clogged injectors. There is a common rail system of one of the first generations and it is quite capricious. Dirt in the fuel tank is even more dangerous for a diesel engine than for a gasoline engine, so filters need to be changed frequently and the cleanliness of the tank must be carefully monitored. Highly running motors can have severe cylinder head corrosion with cracks between valve seats and gas leaks into the cooling jacket. We strongly recommend that you examine the motor with an endoscope when purchasing. True, glow plugs sometimes take years so that they cannot be removed. After restyling, you can find a particular filter on the car. Do not expect good from it. It is not very well compatible with this motor. In general, diesel is not bad at all, but due to the low prevalence and capriciousness of fuel equipment, it is highly not recommended for purchase. On this information about the problems of the Nissan X-Trail T30 is exhausted. If you know more or disagree with what you heard, I'm waiting for you in the comments.